Hello. Morduke here with more Castle of Illusion. In the last exciting installment, we made it to the castle, and we now appear to be in the underbelly of the castle, so to speak, the dungeonous area. Hopefully there's nothing that we have to hack in this dungeon, because I don't think I'm ready for that sort of commitment. More useless treasure. It's like the treasure in Return to Castle Wolfenstein for the PC. It doesn't do anything. There's no point in getting it. I know that the Penny Arcade guy said that it was worth getting for the mere fact that it is treasure. It is inherently worthwhile to get it. But I think that's a load of crap. I like the Penny Arcade guys. They're consistently funny, and they make a lot of good points. But that wasn't one of them. It's like, okay, maybe getting treasure for the sake of getting treasure was fine in 1983. But this is the new millennium, man. I only need one more gem. Go get it and save Minnie. For some reason, there's two gems in the castle. Probably to trick you into thinking this game has more levels than it actually does. This was back in the days when nobody bought video games. The only way they could sell them was through deception. They invented fancy sounding buzzwords and, oh, the marketing hype was unbelievable. It's like, hey everyone, play this game, it uses blast processing. And I'm like, okay, that doesn't mean anything. On the cover of Genesis games, it would often say high definition graphics. And I'm like, wow. HD televisions haven't even been invented yet. But the game already takes advantage of it with its high definition graphics. I love the music for this part. Best tune in the game. This part of the castle is full of machinery. Sorry, had to enjoy the tune there. Usually, machinery looks futuristic and imposing, but this being a Disney game, I actually think they managed to make it look kind of cuddly. You know, it makes the dreary factory, you know, industrial look. You know, it makes it appealing. Everything's so soft and round and cuddly, like these gears. They were designed by the same people who made the Weighted Companion Cube. Which I really shouldn't bring up because I still haven't had a chance to play that game. God, I want to play it so badly. I already know too much about it for having not played it. For instance, I know the cake is a lie. I don't even know what that means. I have no idea what that means in the context of the game. But it's been parroted so much on the internet. Since it's a meme. Don't get me wrong, I would love to play Portal, and as soon as I buy a new computer to replace this one, that would be the first game that I play, most likely. Oh, shit. I plan on upgrading as soon as my federal tax refund arrives, or is deposited, rather. since I chose the direct deposit route. Oh crap, I hate bats. Bats are always the most annoying enemy in any game that contains bats. Castlevania? Actually, the Medusa heads are a little bit more annoying than the bats. But I mean, it's the same general concept. Oh, that was close. Damn it! It's so easy for them to just sneak up under you. But yes, replacement computer. You know what that means? I can actually LP games that are newer than 15 years old. Isn't that exciting? Well, I think it's exciting. I don't care what anybody says, the Genesis has some great music. Sure, its sound technology wasn't quite as good as the Super Nintendo's. But man, you just can't argue with tunes like this one. Oh, I was full of health, so that one gave me 1,000 points instead. 1,000 meaningless points. Dope! Christ. Oh, I hate bats. I hate bats! Whoa. I think that sound means I got an extra try. Sounds so lame when you say it like that. Wow, Mom, look! I got another try! Will you just try as hard as you can, Sonny? I will, Mom. Oh. My God. I really wish more games let you type in the word umbrella and kill all the bats. I don't know how they would have pulled it off on the Genesis, but the option should be there, goddammit. This level's actually pretty long. I'm probably going to cut this video after I beat the boss of this. And then in the next video, I'll fight the last boss. To kill this guy, you have to hit him until he dies. I don't think items work on him. Yeah, you have to lure him close enough to you that he tries to whip you. And then jump on him so he can't. Whoa. When he turns red, that's how you know he's really pissed off. And almost dead. And that is really goddamn red. He should probably see a doctor about that. Because that can't be healthy. Alright, the last gem. The violet one. So you may have noticed something about the colors of these gems. Something. Some sort of pattern to them. All shall be revealed. That's right. They're all the colors of the rainbow. So we can walk on the sweet, sweet rainbow bridge over to the last boss. So I will see you next time on Let's Play Castle Evolution. I'm Duke of the Bump. See you later.